Welcome to Burwood Worship Service.
欢迎大家来参加今天早上的聚会。
I'd like to request all congregation members to silence their mobile phones.
请会众都能把你们的手机电话关掉。
And let's have a minute of silent meditation in our hearts to worship.
请会众能够低头默祷，预备我们的心来敬拜我们的上帝。
Let us begin our worship by singing a sing in His holy temple.
接下来我们开始我们今天的崇拜，我们唱诗，上帝在他的圣殿中。
Holy temple, hush, be still. The Lord is in His holy temple, hush, hush, be still. The Lord is in His temple, now let our nation humbly bow.上帝圣地福音中 Hush, 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 be still. Be still.
One more time.
再唱一遍。
The Lord 在他的手里天中Hush, hush, be still. The Lord is at His holy temple. Hush, hush, be still. The Lord is at His temple now. Let all creation humbly bow.在上帝面前奉心敬 Hush, 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 be still. Be still.
From the invocation, the Lord our GodThe Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength.
宣召，主是我们的上帝，是独一的主，你们要尽心、尽意、尽力爱主，你们的上帝。
The next hymn we're going to sing is 178.
接下来我们要唱诗第178首。
And can it be that I should gain
奇异的爱？
Angela. If you can look at the hymn on the bottom, it's written by Charles Wesley.
大家如果看到下面诗歌下面是这首歌是查理是威斯理写的
And we can tell how much he loved the Lord your God
我们可以知道他是多么的爱我们的上帝
He wrote 6,500 hymns
他写了差不多6,500首的圣诗
That's how much he loved God
他是这样的爱上帝
And let us stand and join together and love God together by singing this hymn
接下来让我们会众一起起立我们一起爱我们的上帝我们唱诗
And can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's blood? Died he for me who caused his pain, for me who seemed 在十字架上。Amazing love, how can it be that thou, my God, should die for me? Amazing love, how can it be that thou, my God, should die for me? This mystery of dies, you can explore its strange design. In vain the firstborn seraph tries to sound the depths of love to find. This mercy all let us adore, that angels died in white no more. Amazing eye, how can it be that thou, my God, shouldst die for me? He left his heart and thrown above, and grace so infinite his praise, tempting himself on dungeon high, and led for Adam's temple's grave. This mercy, oh, immense and great, for oh my God, it found me. Amazing love, how can it be that all my God should die for me? Lord, my prison spirit lay, thus bound in sin and nature's time. Thine eye diffuse a quickening ray, I look to dungeon's sleep with mine. My chains fell off, my heart was free, my soul's strength up and sorrow to see. Amazing eye, how can it be that all my God chooses life for me? No condemnation now I dread, Jesus and all in him is mine. Alive in him, my living soul, and clothed in righteousness divine. Oh, I approach the eternal throne, claim the crown to Christ my own. Amazing love, how can it be that all my soul should die for me?
Please remain standing for opening prayer.
请会众仍然保持站立，我们一起低头祷告。
Our Father, our wise counselor for our life.
我们的父神，我们生活智慧的导师。
You existed way before our birth and planned everything before our time.
在我们出生之前，你已经计划和安排所有的一切。
And we trust, and you are our Savior, our life giver, and our great guardian.
我们相信你是我们的救主，你赐予我们的生命，你是我们伟大的保护者。
You are our Savior because you sent Jesus to die on the cross for us.
你是我们的救主，因为你差遣主耶稣为我们死在十字架上。
And you are our life giver because we live to glorify you.
你是我们的守护者，因为我们活着就是为了要荣耀主。
You are our guardian because each step of our life, you warn us of impending sins.
你是我们的保护者，因为在我们生命中的每一步，你都 提醒告诫我们即将面临的罪。
And therefore, we are here today, just like the Old Testament of Jesus, Moses' time.
因此，我们今天在这里，正如旧约的摩西时代一样。
Where they are gathered together to be taught of your commands and laws.
照着耶稣我们身体所吩咐的，我们将律例和典章教训你们。
And observing them carefully, for this will show your great wisdom and understanding.
要谨守遵行，这就是你们在万民面前的智慧、聪明。
And we have a God that's so near to us that whenever we pray, He can hear us.
上帝在我们求告他的时候与我们相近。
And all this we thank you, Father, for you in your mercy, we can come directly to you.
为着这些，我们要向上帝献上我们的感谢，因为主的怜悯，让我们可以直接来到主你的面前。
And as we assemble here to hear your word, and we learn.To revere you as long as we live.
当我们在这里聚集聆听主你的话语的时候，你为我们召聚百姓，要叫他们听见主你的话，使他们存活在世上的日子。
And we be a light for the world to see your mighty works in our daily life.
我们将如世上的一盏明灯，为我们日常生活中能看到主你的伟大的工程。
And that our children will see our exemplary service accorded to you, our Lord.
而且根据主我们的神，我们的孩子将会看到我们服务的榜样。
Help us to follow your Ten Commandments and never forget your covenant with us.
也帮助我们按照主你的十条诫命，同时让我们永远不要忘记主你跟我们立的约。
In Jesus' name we ask.
奉主耶稣基督的名我们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
会众请坐。
Now we invite the pastor to intercede for us.
我们现在请陈牧师代祷。
大家好。
Good morning, everybody.
冬天了。
It's winter.
好吧，大家见面握握手，说平安。
Let's shake our hands and greet each other.
好，感谢上帝，我们又在一起，一同来敬拜我们的主。
Give thanks God because we are here together again.
今天的聚会是分开两堂。
Today we have two sessions.
所以我们要为着英语施工祷告。
Here we want to pray for English service.
目前几位长老们他们很关心我们的下一代。
Currently, our elders they want to care for our next generations.
他们把工作分配好，来把 来为把英语的施工把它安排好。
They want to make good arrangement for English service.
所以我们要为这个施工祷告。
So we want to pray for English service.
为他们每两个礼拜一次的英语讲员。
We want to pray here for the English speakers.
还有我们的下一代，他们在自己的文化范围里面对福音的反应祷告。
Also pray for our next generation, for them to listen to God's words.
我们用一首的诗歌来预备我们的心，我们来唱有主同在。
We prepare hearts by singing a song in His presence.
主同在，就有安慰。有主同在，有平安。当我寻求父之愈，得着只有父的确据，不是因三主同在，有你同在，就有安慰。有你同在，我寻求你心愿，得着只有父的确据，你的圣洁常同在。
再一次，
有主同在，就有安慰。我心求父之愈，得着只有父的确据，都是因三主同在，有你同在，就有安慰。有你同在，有平安。当我寻求你心愿，得着只有父的确据，你的圣洁常同在。
我们同心祷告。
Let's unite our hearts and pray.
感谢上帝，你应许与我们同在。
We thank God that you promise to be with us.
一直到世界的末了。
Till the end of the world.
我们也感谢上帝，当我们两三个人在一起奉你的名聚会的时候，你应许你在我们中间与我们同在。
We also thank God because you have promised you will be among us. When two or three of us gather in your name,
感谢上帝，当你同在的时候，把平安、把安慰都赐给我们。
We thank God because you give us peace and comfort when you are with us.
天父，我们为我们教会的英语施工祷告。
Lord, we pray for English service in this church.
感谢上帝，给我们属灵的家庭。
We thank God for giving us a spiritual family.
我们有不同的文化，不同的背景。
We come from different cultural backgrounds.
但是我们都是上帝的儿女。
We are all your children.
天父，我们的下一代，他们常使用当地的文字语言来反应，来沟通。
Lord, our next generation use the local language to communicate with you.
求上帝恩待，让英语的施工给他们安排一个好的环境，可以学习成长。
Please bless them, also bless the English, and give them a good environment to learn your words.
正如今天有讲英语的讲员。
Also today, the English speaker.
我们求上帝使用他。
We ask God to make good use of him.
也恩待我们的下一代能够领会你的话语。
Please also guide our next generation to understand your words.
恩待复制英语施工的同工们。
Bless those who are serving in English service.
给他们智慧，给他们能力。
Give them wisdom and capacity.
天父，我们把这一切都交托给你。
Lord, we bring all this in your hands.
我们今天到在这段时间 有人出远门探亲度假。
Here we remember those who are going overseas to travel or visiting families.
恩待他们平安回来。
Please guide them to come safely.
也继续恩待身体欠安的弟兄姐妹们。
Also bless those who are unwell.
我们把黄老先生继续交托给你。
We bring Mr. Huang into your hands.
求上帝恩待他。
Please protect him.
求上帝把康宁平安加在他的身上。
Please grant him a healthy body and peace.
奉耶稣基督的名。
We pray in your name.
Amen.
Amen.
And following on is the reading of the Holy Scripture.
接下来呢，我们一起聆听上帝的话语。
We continue the study of Old Testament from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 4, verse 1 to 12.
我们继续学习旧约圣经《生命记》。
And we will invite Mr. Michael Chen to read for us the first 6 verses, and Mr. Eric Chung to read for us the subsequent verses.
请陈勇弟兄中文读经《生命记》第四章一节到六节。Eric 英文读经《生命记》第四章七节到第十二节。旧约圣经《生命记》第四章第一节：以色列人啊，现在我所教训你们的律例、典章，你们要听从遵行，好叫你们存活，得以进入耶和华你们列祖之上帝所赐给你们的地，承受为业。所吩咐你们的话，你们不可加添，也不可删减，好叫你们遵守我所吩咐的，就是耶和华你们上帝的命令。耶和华因巴利比尔的事所行的，你们亲眼看见的。凡随从巴利比尔的人，耶和华你们的上帝都从你们中间除灭了。唯有你们专靠耶和华你们上帝的人，今日全都存活。我照着耶和华我上帝所吩咐的，将律例、典章教训你们，使你们在所要进去得为业的地上遵行。第六节，所以你们要遵守，你们要谨守遵行，这就是你们在万民面前的智慧、聪明。他们听见这一切律例，必说：这大国的人真是有智慧、有聪明。
We continue the reading in English from verses 7 to 12. What other nation is so great as to have their gods near them the way the Lord our God is near us whenever we pray to Him? And what other nation is so great as to have such righteous decrees and laws as this body of laws I am setting before you today? Only be careful and watch yourselves closely, so that you do not forget the things your eyes have seen, or let them fade from your hearts as long as you live. Teach them to your children and to their children after them. Remember the day you stood before the Lord your God at Horeb, when he said to me, Assemble the people before me to hear my words, so that they may learn to revere me as long as they live in the land, and may teach them to their children. You came near and stood at the foot of the mountain while it blazed with fire to the very heavens, with black clouds and deep darkness. Then the Lord spoke to you out of the fire. You heard the voice of words, but saw no form. There was only a voice. This is the word of God.
感谢上帝赐给我们他的话语。
这一段的经文
the part of scripture we have read just now,
这是提到上帝
赐给我们本不配得的恩典。
Here he tells us God's undeserved gifts to us.
生命记这本书也不断地提到上帝的恩典。
So in this book, the third Deuteronomy, he also mentioned very often the gifts of God to us.
这里就提到上帝给我们恩典的中的两样东西。
So here I refer to the gift of God, the two things he gives to us.
上帝赐下的话语，还有上帝所赐给我们的土地。
So the words he gave, the land he provided.
所以上帝不但是带领他的子民的上帝，
So God not only is the God that guides his people，
他也是应许赐给他们所应许的上帝。
Also he is the God that gives his people the promise，
上帝知道他们所需要的。
And God knows what they need，
当然其中一个是土地。
So one of themis the land.
他们可以安居定居下来。
The land they can there, they stay can stay there.
但是除了土地以外，
so apart from the land,
还有一个他们更需要的上帝的话语。
So one of the most important thing is the words of God.
所以上帝把这两样东西赐给我们。
So God has given us these two things.
这是我们本不配得的恩典。
So that is the undeserved gift that we have.
提到上帝的话语，
Here refer to the words of God.
我先把要讲的四样事情提出来。
So here I would like to refer to the four things. Here I would like to tell you.
这个律法或者话语主要的目的是赐给人生命。
So what the law or the word is designed to impart life.
这个律法或者话语的目的是增进知识，启迪人心，还有触发思想。
So the law or the word is designed to inform, enlighten, and stimulate the mind.
这个律法或者话语防止我们犯罪，也保护我们不受有害的那些具毁灭性食物的影响，免得我们失去上帝要我们过的那一种幸福生活。
The law, the word, guard us from sin and protects us from those harmful and destructive influences which would rob us of the happy life God intends us to enjoy.
这个律法话语连对世人都非常有吸引力，它不但转化我们的人生，而且在我们不信主的邻居心中留下深刻的印象。
The law or word not only transform our own lives, but makes a profound impact on our unbelieving neighbors.
这今天这一段经文教导我们要记得的四样的事情。
So that's the thing today's passage would teach us the fourth, these four things.
也是从四样的事情，我们可以明白这是上帝的恩典。
And from these four things, then we realize that is the grace of God.
我们本不配得的。
So that is the gift, we are not deserving it.
这四章第一节说，以色列人啊，现在我教训你们的律例典章，你们要听从遵行，好叫你们存活，得以进入耶和华你们列祖之神所赐给你们的地，承受为业。
So here I say, Hear now, O Israel, the decrees and laws I am about to teach you. Follow them so that you may live and may go in and take possession of the land that the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you.
先做一个解释一下。
So here I will give a bit of explanation.
什么叫做律例？什么叫做典章？
What is decree? And what is law? What is law?
这个律例是讲到永久性的行为规范。
So the decree means the permanent rules of conduct.
上帝给我们一个标准，一个原则。
So God give us a standard and also a set of rules.
什么叫典章？就判决，就决定下来。
What is law? It means judicial decisions.
这个都是讲到上帝的话语。
And this all refer to the words of God.
这上帝的话语对我们来说，这个生活的标准。
So, the words of God to us, in fact, is the standard, the guide of our lives.
不单是生活的标准，它还决定我们所做的是对或者不对。
Not only is the standard of our life, but also try to decide the one we have done, is it right or wrong?
这是上帝的话语赐给我们的一个其中的目的。
So that is the aim the words of God is giving to us.
上帝的律法或者上帝的话语主要的目的是给我们人生命。
So the law or the word is designed to impart life to us.
这告诉我们每次把圣经打开来 我们来读的时候,
Here is that whenever we open the Bible and read the words,
这是上帝的话语来供应我们的生命,
and that is the words of God to provide to our lives.
它给我们生命的需要,
they give up to provide us the needs
就是说,
in our lives.
属灵的粮食可以从上帝的话语里面可以得着。
That means it's a spiritual food from the words of God to provide to our lives.
第二，这个律法或者话语。 目的是增加我们的知识，可以启迪人心，可以触发我们的思想。
The law or word is designed to inform, enlighten, and stimulate our mind.
每一次圣经提到上帝的话要给我们的时候，
So every time in the Bible refer to that the words of God were given to us,
上帝只是把这句话先提出来。
God is put this sentence forward.
是上帝所看重的，不是上帝给了他的子民。对不起，这个打应该是错了，错了。不是我们给他什么，是上帝给了我们什么。
So here he say focusing on what he first gave to his people, and not what they give to God.
对，这个中文就打错了。不是我们给上帝什么，是上帝给我们什么。
Not that we have given God something, but it's God have given us something.
是上帝先主动给我们。
God actively give us something.
我们有所领受以后，
we have received something.
我们才能够把它做出来。
Then we can do it ourselves.
这是上帝的话语在我们心中的目的。
So that is the words of God that he want to give us in his purpose of doing that.
不但给我们生命，
Not only give us life,
不但增加知识,
not only give us the knowledge,
还鼓励我们,
but also encourage us,
就是推动我们,
and also stimulate us.
如果有机会去广州黄花岗, 那72烈士,
if you got opportunity, go to Canton or Guangzhou, you visit the Huanghua Gang.
我们不要以为这不过是中国历史的一部分而已。
You don't take that as only a memorial about the Chinese history.
在72个烈士里面,
of the 72 martyrs,
其中大部分都是宣教士、传道人、基督徒。
Most of them are missionaries, Christians, and preachers.
他们知道真理是什么。
They know what is the truth.
他们知道国家对国家尽的责任。
They also know what is the responsibility towards the country.
对他们成为72个历史里面的一些人。
So these are the some of the 72 martyrs.
你看，这不是中国历史的一部分而已。
This is not just part of the Chinese history.
讲到基督徒 明白上帝的话语。
Here, refer a Christian to know the words of God.
上帝的话语就鼓励他。
God's words encourage them.
教导他。 显着什么是对，什么是不对。
To teach them to know what is the right thing and what's the wrong thing.
鼓励他去推动他去做正确的事情。
To stimulate them to do the right thing.
其中一个，我父孙中山先生。
The one is Dr. Sun Yat-sen.
Our national father. Huh? 我们的国父, national father.
Oh, our national father. Our national father, Dr. Sun Yat-sen.
他在最困难的时候，
during his most difficult time,
是他在教会里面那些基督徒们在他旁边鼓励他。
There in the church, there are a group of Christians in the church try to encourage him.
所以我们知道上帝的话语给人的影响力是那么的大。
So we know the words of God how much influence towards people.
讲到上帝的话语。
When we refer to the words of God,
我们要读。
We have to read them.
我们要明白。
We have to understand them.
我们要同人分享。
We also to share with other people.
这一条蛇。
This is the snake.
大家知道圣经在那里有提到这一条蛇。
You know, in the Bible, what is the part they mention about the snake?
这一条蛇是圣经里面第一位的圣经学者。
So this snake is the first biblical scholar.
是圣经里面提到第一个圣经的学者。
So here, in the Bible, we have the first biblical scholar.
他研究上帝的话语。
He studied the words of God.
他把上帝的话语传达给夏娃。
He used the words of God pass on to Eve.
他就对着夏娃的软弱。
And here, he looking at the weakness of Eve.
夏娃的迷惑。
And also the
confused.
The confused nature of Eve.
他就把上帝的话语把它曲解。
And here, he trying to explain the words of God.
是他是第一个圣经提到的圣经学者。
Here is the first biblical scholar.
但很可惜，他读错了。
But it's quite a great pity he misinterpreted the words of God.
他讲错了。
He said the wrong.
结果他也传错了。
Also, the message also gave the wrong message.
所以我们要回到上帝的话语里面。
When we return to the words of God,
我们怎么样能够明白上帝的话语？
How to understand the words of God?
上帝的话语不是好像看一本书一样。
The words of God is not just that you read a book.
看一次就够了。
You read once and that's enough.
看一次就放在那里。
After you read once, you leave a behind.
这不是我们对上帝的话语应该有的态度。
So that is not the way we do the we treat the words of God.
读圣经这个态度方法。应该学习把自己的人生读进圣经人物的人生里面。
So the best way, the right way to read the Bible is learning to read our lives into the lives of Moses.
这段的时间，我们一直不断的听到摩西的生平。
So lately, we mention very often about the life of Moses.
摩西是谁
？Who is Moses?
摩西是以色列人的民族英雄。
Moses is the heroes of the Israel.
还同我们有什么关系？
What does it relate to us?
当我们读圣经的时候，
When we read the Bible,
如果我们只是把摩西当作以色列的民族英雄，
If we take Moses as one of the heroes of this Israelites,
我们就没有把自己的人生读进摩西的人生里面。
Then we would not have read our lives into the lives of Moses.
在当我们读圣经提到摩西的时候，
When we read the Bible referring to Moses,
我们把自己放在摩西里边。
We put ourselves into the life of Moses.
摩西所遇到的困难。
So the difficulty Moses has come across.
摩西的经历。
Experience Moses passed through.
也是我所遇到的困难。
It's also the same difficulty we have come across.
也是我的经历。
It's also our experience.
摩西胜过这一切。
Well, when Moses is living through all this,
也是帮助我能够胜过这些困难。
It also help us to living through all this problems.
所以读圣经里面的任何一个人物，
So we read in the Bible whatever type of biblical figures,
不要把这个人物把它放在那里。
We don't put this person figures there.
只是尊敬他而已。
Not just as respect them.
我们就进到他的生命里面。
We have to enter into his life.
我就是摩西。
I.Moses.
我就是彼得。
I'm Peter.
我就是保罗。
I'm Paul.
把自己读进他的生活人生里面。
We read ourselves into their lives.
当我们这样子读的时候，
When you say read in this way,
我们就发现圣经里面的文字不是单单文字，是传递心灵意义、力量还有真理。
When you do this way, we discover that words are never mere words. They convey spirit, meaning, energy, and truth.
不是单单写下来的文字
，not just only written words，
它传达心灵意义、真理
，but it convey the spirit, the meaning, energy, and truth，
带给我们力量
，give us the strength。
我们那个老师 Eugene Peterson，
my teacher Eugene Peterson，
他读圣经，他真的是把自己放在圣经里面。
So he read the Bible, he put himself into the words.
他懂得圣经的原文。
He know the original meaning of the Bible.
他就用他所能够经历、能够体会的把它表达出来。
So he take what he understand, what he's feeling, express it out to people.
我把诗篇二十三篇给大家看。
Here, I take Psalm 23 and as an illustration.
你们大家。有的能够背诵诗篇二十三篇
，You know, many of us know how to recite Psalm 23.
我想在我们的思想里面，我们可以表达这个诗篇二十三篇。
I believe through our understanding, we can express the meaning of Psalm 23.
因为我们同这个他所写的诗篇二十三篇把它比较一下。
So let's compare with what he understand and what he interpret Psalm 23.
我们大家先用。华语来读一篇。
We read this in Chinese first.
上帝啊，我的牧者，我什么都不要，你把我放在绿意盎然的草场上，又找到安静的水给我饮用。你们的反应怎么样
？What is your feeling?
很亲切吗
？Is that very intimate to you?
正如你话所说的。你让我歇息，并指示我正确的方向。即使经过死亡之谷，但有你与我同行，我就不惧怕。你可靠的牧掌使我觉得安心。就在我的敌人面前，你为我预备丰富的晚宴。你抬起我低垂的头，我的背满带福祉。有我生之年的每一天。你的美善和慈爱都紧随着我，我要回到神居所内的家度过一生。好 ，English please.
English. God, my shepherd, I don't need a thing. You have bedded me down in lush meadows. You find me quiet pools to drink from. True to your word, you let me catch my breath and send me into the right directions. Even whenWhen I go through the dead valley, I'm not afraid when you walk at my side. Your trusted shepherd's crook make me feel sure, secure. You serve me a six-course dinner right in front of my enemies. You revive my dropping head, my cup brims with blessings. Your beauty and love chase after me every day of my life. I'm back home in the house of God the rest of my life.
我想读这样子来读诗篇二十三篇，我们就更容易表达我们同上帝的关系。
So you read Psalm 23, we can even see how closely God's link to us.
这就是告诉我们，我们读圣经的时候
，Here you referring to when you read the Bible，
把我们放在那个场地里边。
We put ourselves in that type of environment.
我们读诗篇二十三篇
，We read Psalm 23，
我们就是那一只羊。
We just like this.
我们就是在那草场上的 那些羊。
We also just like this sheep on the middle.
看到上帝的带领。
You see how God.
上帝的保护。
How God protected.
是，这是读圣经的方法。
So that is the word. Read.
把自己的人生读进他的人生里面。
We read our life into the lives of those who are in the Bible.
第二节所吩咐你们的话，你们不可加添，也不可删减，好叫你们遵守我所吩咐的，就是耶和华你们上帝的命令。
Verse two, yeah, do not add to what I command you, and do not subtract from it, but keep the commands of the Lord your God that I give.
上个礼拜我们有提到这个事情。
Last week we refer to these things.
上帝的话，我们不可以随便增加，也不可以随便删减。
The words of God, we cannot add to them or we can subtract of them.
在人类的历史里面，有不同的人用不同的方法来增加、来删减上帝的话语。
During the history of mankind, people try to add to the words of God and also subtract some of them.
其中一个在耶稣的时代，那个法利赛人和撒都盖人。
So during the time of Jesus, the Pharisees and also the Sadducees.
这个撒都盖人是在上帝的话不断的增加。
The Pharisees add the words of God and try to keep on adding to them.
撒都盖人是在上帝的话里不断的删减。
The Sadducees try to take some of the words off, take it off to fit the requirements.
这就是法利赛人和撒都盖人。
So these are the figures like the Pharisees and the Sadducees.
这法利赛人是第一世纪的教条主义者，撒都盖人则是同一个时代有破坏性的理性主义者。
The Pharisees were the first century legalists, and the Sadducees the destructive nationalists of that day.
我们不要怪他们，他们怎么可以把上帝的话语把它增加又把它删减？
We soon blame them how they add to the words of God or subtract the words of God.
记得，基督徒把圣经里面没有说的事情加在别人的身上当做规条，就是加添上帝的话语。
Remember the believers add to words of God whenever they make compulsory rules about things on which scripture is silent.
今天我们大家多数都是中年人。
Today we are all middle-aged people.
我们做礼拜喜欢比较保持安静。
So we have service, church service, we try to be bit quiet.
有人说基督徒唱歌。
Someone say Christians to sing.
应该站起来。
And stand up.
不但站起来唱歌。
Not only stand up and sing.
有半个钟头站起来唱歌。
And also sing for half an hour.
那是真正的敬拜赞美。
So that is the way to praise God.
圣经里面有这个话吗？
Is there any word written like that?
圣经里面有这样的记载吗？
Is there any scripture written in this type of words?
为什么过去唱歌没有告诉我们要站起来半个钟头呢？
Why do we sing and praise God and we stand up for half an hour?
所以我们把这些圣经里面没有讲的，把它加在人家的身上当做规条，那就是增加上帝的话语。
We put this type of way that not even written in the Bible and ask people you have to follow this type of way and that is what you call the rules.
如果我们不遵从上帝的话语,
if we don't believe and obey the words of God,
把上帝的话语当作耳边风,
and we take the words of God just go through like wind through our ears,
我们就等于删减减少上帝的话语。
There, you more or less like subtract the words of God.
所以这都是增加或者删减上帝的话语的一种行动。
So that is the type of action like add to the words of God or subtract the words of God.
第三告诉我们这个律法，上帝的话语防止我们犯罪，也保护我们不受有害的毁灭性事物的影响，免得我们舍弃上帝要我们过那一种幸福的生活。
The first point, law or words of God, guard us from sin and protect us from those harmful and destructive influences which would rob us of the happy life God intends us to enjoy.
所以上帝为了保护我们,
if God wants to protect us,
摩西就提到过去发生的事情,
Moses here referred to what things have happened in the past.
就是在巴利比尔所发生的事情。
And that's where it happened in Ba-Per, the area.
在那里，以色列人的男丁和当地的女子发生关系。
There, the Israelite male tried to have a relationship with the female of the locals.
在那里，以色列人离开上帝，拜偶像。
There, the Israelites left God and worshipped the idol.
所以上帝就处理他们。
God there tried to punish them.
摩西把这个事件重新提出来。
Moses tried to remind this again to them.
是给他们看到两个对比，一个是生命之道，还有一个死亡之道。
So let them see the comparison, the way of life and the way of death.
如果不听从,不遵行, 就是违背。
If you don't follow, don't obey, that means you try to stay away.
那就是放弃生命之道,选择死亡之道。
There you give away the way of life and choose the path, the way of death.
上帝为了保护他们,
God, because we want to protect them,
就把这个警告再一次提出来。
And here, give them the warning and remind them once again.
还是要遵行上帝的话语。
You have to follow the words of God.
第四,这律法,上帝的话语, 连对一般人都有很大的吸引力, 它不但改变我们的人生, 还有给我们那些不信主的邻居, 留下一个很好深刻的印象。
The fourth point, the law was not only transform our own life, but make profound impact on our unbelieving neighbors.
So 第六节、第八节告诉我们,
so verse 6 and 8 tell us,
你们听见这些律例, 必说这大国的人正是有智慧、有聪明, 有哪一个大国有这样公义的律法、律例典章, 像我今日在你们面前所陈明,
so who will hear about all these decrees and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people? And what other nation is so great as to have such righteous decrees and laws as this body of laws I am setting before you today?
就是上帝的话语不但改变我们的人生,
so the words of God not only change our lives,
在我们是周围的人看到我们的时候,
the people around us in our environment have seen us,
也给他们留下个很深刻的印象,
or give us a very strong impression,
对我们的上帝觉得不但好奇,
not only God is just a great God,
他们会寻找我们的上帝,
not only the one who can seek us,
他们会认识会敬拜我们的上帝,
then the one who will worship him.
我们太多听到不好的消息,
we have listened bad, lots of bad news.
把电视机打开的时候,
you turn on the television,
我们收看是那些战争饥荒,
you can see some of the famine, some of the law in this world,
那些疾病灾难,
and also the sickness around.
好像没有好消息,
it seems there are no good news.
圣经里面提到上帝的恩典,
when in the Bible referring to the grace of God,
在这个时代还看到上帝的恩典吗?
In this type of ages, do we still the grace of God?
我们似乎看到上帝的恩典慢慢地消失了。
It seems we can see the grace of God slowly disappearing.
在澳洲似乎没有看到上帝的恩典。
In Australia, we doesn't seem to see the grace of God.
在别的地方, 还有看到上帝的恩典吗?
In other places, do you see the grace of God?
圣经的话告诉我们说,
the Bible tells us,
那些不信主的邻居会看到我们上帝。
Those unbelieving neighbors would see our God.
我们这里看不到上帝的恩典。
We cannot see the grace of God.
那在另外地方, 我们仍然看到上帝的恩典。
But in other places, people can see the grace of God.
时代, Time 杂志的记者, Mr. David Edmond.
So the Time magazine is a reporter, David Aiken.
他在这个 Time magazine 做了20多年。
He's been working in this Time magazine for over 20 odd years.
有他周游世界50个国家。
He's been traveling around over 50 odd countries in the world.
当他来到中国的时候,
when he came to China,
他就写了这一篇, Jesus in Beijing.
He has written this message, Jesus in Beijing.
耶稣在北京,
Jesus in Beijing.
他就把这20多年的工作放下来。
There he'll give away the 20 odd years of work he have done.
他就留在中国把上帝的恩典向中国人所显明的一切把它记录下来。
He's there. He stayed in China, in Beijing, and written, recording all the grace of God that given to the Chinese.
那个时候，解放前，中国有7000个宣教师。
So before the changeover of China, in China there are 7,000 missionaries.
有超过900间的大型的医院。
There are over 900 big hospitals.
有6000个学校。
There are 6,000 schools.
包括大学。
Including university.
其中最大的宣教机构叫做中华内地会。
There, the biggest missionary organization is the China Inland Mission.
1949年过了以后。
After 1949,
毛泽东一夜之间讲句话。
毛泽东 in one night say something. It's one word, one sentence.
所有的宣教士统统都要离开。
He said, all the missionaries have to leave China right away.
7000多名的宣教士都离开。
7,000 missionaries.
那个是中华内地会的主要办公室是在澳洲这里。
So the China Inland Mission is coming set in Australia.
他们主要的公他们办公室在这里。
Their office in Australia.
所以他们就在那里讨论。
There, they discuss.
是不是要把所有的宣教师把他带出来
？Is that we have to take all the missionary out of China?
把这个工作把它解散。
And we dispose of this work in China.
或者把宣教师把它分派到东南亚其他的地方。
Or spread this missionary in Southeast Asia and spread them out.
那些宣教师离开的时候
，So when the missionary left,
不是好好的离开。
Not just left in a very decent way.
都非常的失望。
They are all very disappointed.
有的精神崩溃。
And some of them even have this nervous breakdown.
他们就要这样子离开中国。
Because they won't leave.
过了十多年。
After 10 over years.
有的宣教士重新回到他们原来工作的地方。
Some missionaries return to their original place of work.
当发现一些都改变过来。
They find out things have changed.
中国的基督徒估计有1亿这么多。
Chinese Christians, there are over 100 million.
不正式的统计，差不多占人口的10%。
So in an
unofficial.
Published record, there's nearly 1/10 of the population.
这是历史上最大的人数复兴。
That is the largest religious revival in history.
没有人在旁边指示他们。
No one there to teach them.
没有外国的力量推动他们。
No foreign force to motivate them.
经过那么大的困难。
After all these difficulties.
突然间，教会又被开荒。
Then the church being revived.
基督徒重新回到上帝的家。
And Christians back to the house of God.
所以历史学家说，21世纪是中国的世纪。
So the historians say, 21st century called the Chinese century.
这个话不是那么简单可以讲出来。
This word is not simply easily said.
今天的中国教会
，Today's Chinese Church，
他们有归回耶路撒冷的运动。
They have the Back to Jerusalem movement.
什么叫做归回耶路撒冷的运动
？What does it mean by Back to Jerusalem movement？
中国的教会沿着丝绸的路，动员派出10万名宣教师，气象。中国耶路撒冷之间的50个国家传福音。
The Chinese Church is mobilizing to send 100,000 missionaries along the Silk Road, hoping to evangelize the 51 countries located in China and Jerusalem.
我有个同学
，I have a schoolmate.
上帝给他传福音的恩赐。
God gave him the talent to spread the gospel.
在印尼传福音，带领人悔改。
So in Indonesia, try to bring people back to God.
又突然间，这个同学 他就不知道他走到到底去哪里。
And suddenly, this schoolmate not know where he's gone to.
我们也有三十年的时间没有见面。
We have nearly 30 odd years we haven't seen each other.
等到见面的有一天见他的时候
，So one day we met.
人已经不一样了。
He is different.
我他重新，好像年轻时候有那一种传福音的热忱。
But he still had that earnest when he was young, want to spread the gospel.
他最近从印尼寄给我 email.
So recently he gave me email from Indonesia.
你知道那个 email 的字，不像我在这里打出来的这么小字。
You know the email, not just one I printed out, the small letters.
每一个字好像拇指这么大。
Every word is like my thumb, the size of my thumb.
吓了一跳，有这么大字的眼睛。
So, how come we get a message with this last the last characters?
最后他告诉我
，Finally he told me，
他说刚刚从国内回来
，Just returned from China。
九月份还要再去
，September I will go back again。
到九月份去的时候
，So during September when I'm going，
他要在那里安立五十个牧师。
There he will ordain 51 ministers。
我暂时保留，我不提这个地名。
I right now I want to keep these places not be publicized.
九月份我要倒回去，要安立五十位牧师。
So when I return in September, I will go back to ordain 51 ministers.
他说明年你一定要跟我去。
He said, John, you have to come with me.
我很受感动。
I've been touched.
他写的字是那么大，大型的字。
He had written the word such big characters.
走路都有人来陪着他。
And when he walked, someone had accompanied him.
他还是带着这么强烈福音的热忱到中国传福音。
He still bring this earnest go back to China to spread gospel.
还有预备九月份到那里去安立五十个牧师。
And in September, you're going to ordain 51 ministers.
他说明年你要不要去
But ？John, you come.
你知道我怎么回答
？How do I say?
我挣扎
I struggle
我说我好好预备
I said oh I try to prepare
看看为这五十个人我怎么样子做培训的工作
I see how I'm going to
为这五十个要被安利的牧师做一些培训的工作
So how I'm going to assist for this 51 minister that you're going to be ordained
从他所分享的好消息
From the message, he shared good news with me.
我们就看到在这里似乎看不到上帝的恩典。
It seems here we cannot see the grace of God.
但是好像这一位 Time 的记者 David Edmund 一样。
Just like this Time magazine, David Aiken.
他一到中国看见福音的成长。
There I can see the growth of gospel in China.
就把二十年的工作放下来。
Then he gave up 20 odd years work.
就留在那里把上帝的恩典给中国的恩典把它记录下来。
So he stayed in China recording the grace of God that happened in China.
中国会不会不仅是全球经济的领袖同时也成为基督信仰的中心
So China emerged not just as a global economic leader but as the next major center of Christian faith.
什么是我们的反应
？What is our response？
我们怎么回答呢
？How we reply this？
我们只能坐待静观。
We can only wait and see。
上帝的话语是赐给人生命。
The words of God give impart life to people。
上帝的话语增进知识，启迪人心，触发思想。
The words of God to inform, enlighten, and stimulate。People's mind.
上帝的话语防止我们犯罪。
God's word guard us from sin.
在我们的邻居不幸的邻居留下深刻的印象。
That we have a profound impact on our neighbors.
这是上帝赐给我们本不配得的恩典。
God's undeserved gift to us.
我们低头祷告。
Bow in prayer.
天父，你把这我们本不配得的恩典 赐给了我们。
Heavenly Father, you have given us that undeserved gift that we soon have.
把宝贵的福音话语赐给了我们。
You give us this gospel and also your words to us.
不但给我们生命，
not only give us life,
增加我们的知识，
and increase our knowledge,
推动我们，
to stimulate us,
保守我们过一个幸福的生活，
to protect us from all the sinful life.
还有让万民知道我们的上帝是何等的伟大。
So that other people can see how great our God is.
我们感谢上帝。
Yeah, I will give you thanks.
把那本不配得的恩典赐给了我们。
He gave us this undeserved gift to us.
奉耶稣基督的名。
In Jesus' name we pray.
阿门。我们来唱一首的诗歌。
We sing a hymn.
主，我如何报答？
Oh, how can I repay?
Yeah.
心看，我的呼求你圣旨的名。
How can we repay what God's undeserving gift to us?
我们怎样才能报答神赐给我们本不配得的恩典？
But we can give him our best.
可是我们可以把我们最好的奉献给他。
Because indeed, Deuteronomy has said, each of you must bring a gift in proportion to the way the Lord your God has blessed you.
圣经生命记说，我们应该把我们最好的奉献给我们的上帝。
Let us offer to God thankfully, joyfully, in gratitude for what He has done for us.
请会众以自由喜乐的心来奉献，来报答上帝给我们所做的一切。
We invite the four brothers to wait upon us.
我们请四位弟兄上前受奉献。
Please rise for the Thanksgiving prayer.
请会众一起起立，我们做奉献感恩祷告。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for our salvation and our sanctification in Jesus.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢我们主耶稣的救恩和成圣。
For the Lord Jesus has given us so much, and even died on the cross for our lives.
主耶稣给了我们这么多，甚至为我们的生命而死在十字架上。
And we thank you so much for our salvation that is so rich and free.
我们也感谢主，你为我们的救恩是如此的丰富和自由。
And here, this offering we bring before you, may it be used for the extension of your kingdom.
今天我们在主面前的奉献，愿它能够扩大主你的国度上。
Please accept this offering we bring before you.
愿主能够悦纳我们今天早上所奉献上。
And bless all those who offered you.
愿主能够赐予那些喜乐奉献的人。
In Jesus' name we thank.
奉主耶稣基督的名，我们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
会众请坐。
And next is the announcement.
接下来是我们报告的时间。
And please fill in the attendance register in front of you.
在我们报告的时候，请会众能够轮流填写出席表。
And if you are new among us, we welcome you.
如果你是第一次来参加聚会的朋友们，我们欢迎你们。
And if there's any change of address or of contact number, please fill in there as well.
如果你们当中有改变你们地址或者联系方式的，也请你们写下来。
This week there's two Bible study. Just before that, after the worship.This morning, after the worship this morning, there's a Chinese baptismal class going on.
今天聚会完毕之后，我们有中文慕道班。
Conducted by our pastor.
由我们陈牧师带领。
In preparation for those who are getting baptized.
给那些要准备接受洗礼的。
And this week there are two Bible studies going on.
这个礼拜我们有两个小组聚会。
And one is the Ladies Grace Chinese Ladies Group.
第一个是恩惠国语小组聚会。
This Friday 7:30, they meet in the church.
这个礼拜五晚上七点在我们的教会护堂举行。
And if you'd like to know more about it, please see Yvonne.
如果你们想知道更多的信息，可以跟 Yvonne 姐妹联系。
And next is the men's pilgrim group.
接下来是另外一个弟兄小组聚会。
Will be held in Elder Louis Wong's place.
在黄义强长老夫妇负山举行。
That's 8 o'clock this Friday.
也是礼拜五晚上8点。
It's a good reminder that we have to study God's Word.
在这里是好的提醒，我们一定要学习上帝的话语。
That will help us and guide us in our life.
它可以帮助我们，指导我们在我们的生活中。
And also on Saturday,
还有这个礼拜六,
it's working bee between 9 to 2 p.m.
是我们教会的义务劳动的是早上9点到下午2点。
And if you want to offer your time and your effort to the to God,
如果你们要奉献你们的时间跟精力给我们的上帝,
it's a good time to come along and bring your tools to help up to clean up the church.
希望你们都能够, 参加, 然后预备你们的一些工具, 来清洁我们的教会。
Maybe if you are in the audio, you can clean up your computers.
如果你们是在那个, 音响侍奉的话, 你们可以分别清洁一下那些音响的设备。
If you're involved with the kitchen, you like to clean up the kitchen.
如果你们是在 厨房的 施工的话, 你们可以顺便清理一下厨房。
If you're a music team, you like to clean up the piano.
如果你们是在音乐施工的话, 你们可以顺便清洁一下你们的钢琴。
Put that in your prayer.
也把这些放在你们祷告上。
And that ends my announcement.
报告到此为止。
Please rise for the doxology.
请会众一起起立, 我们一起唱诗上一首。
真神万物之根，一生生灵当光护恒，天上万军送赞助命，同为神父神之神灵。阿门。会众人人起立。 祝福, please remain standing for benedictions. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us always. 愿我主耶稣基督的恩惠，天父上帝的慈爱，圣灵的感动交通，常与我中弟兄姐妹们同在，直到永远。阿门。
阿门。
Please be seated.